last lesson, we began our study of the town, and we learned it was more than a story of a few people in Grover's Corners, New Hampshire. That the play made us see the town, its people, and ourselves in relation to the whole universe. Now, in this lesson, we'll try to discover what we get from the play, what the play tells us about ourselves. But before we go into that, let's see if we can't learn something more about the way Mr. Wilder tells his story. Now, in our last lesson, we discussed briefly how he used the stage. No curtain, you remember? No scenery, no props. And how he made use of the stage manager and flashbacks into the past and dead people talking. These things are all part of his technique. They help him to tell his particular kind of story by making us, the audience, use our imagination. But Mr. Wilder's art is more than that. The playwright's art is complex and demanding. For one thing, he is forever working against time. In our modern theater, the curtain goes up by 8:40 and goes down at 11 p.m. And everything must be said in time limit. Now, to tell a story like that of our town, to create feelings in an audience, in the kind of ideas discussed in our last lesson, and to do all of this within 2 hours is quite a job. Now, there are many of them that show you all of them, but we'll discuss only three. Here they are. One, the use of music. Two, theme and variation, which I'll explain later. And three, the use of the condensed line, or word. Let's begin by considering the use of music in the play. In our first lesson, you remember, we mentioned what music does for us, and we said it helps us to express our feelings, and we listened to some music, remember?
Look out at the camera, look straight at the camera.
Music, when soft voices die, vibrates in the memory. Well, playwrights like Mr. Wilder know that music vibrates in the memory.